Hey guys, so today we're gonna be doing a new foundation first impressions wear test. This is the L'Oreal Infallible Long Wear Shaping Stick Foundation, and I also have the highlighters that released with the foundation and the blush. As you can see, Amazon beauty packaging strikes again. Some of them were wrapped and none of them were bubble wrapped, so forewarning, if you order these on Amazon, which is the only place that I have seen them, that's what you're gonna get right now. All of the products in today's video retails for $10.99 on Amazon, Prime shipping. The foundations themselves have SPF 27. I do not believe the highlighters or the blush does as well. They're all supposed to be really creamy and easy and on the go. The foundation itself is supposed to be a medium to full coverage and a nice blendable, never cakey feel. That's the claim at least.
The packaging is kind of cute. It has a little artsy reflective decals on it. This is how much product you get.
So excuse my eyelashes. As you can see, I am due for a fill as far as my extensions go. So there's a little definition, but not a lot. So today I have two of the 12 shades. Yes, there's only 12 shades for this foundation. Stick foundations really don't have that many shades, it seems. First shade would be 406 and the second shade is 407. So I have warm beige and I have natural beige. Warm beige is way too light. I can give you guys that. That's why I ordered natural beige. I'll give you guys a comparison swatch. This is warm beige and this is natural beige. Warm beige is super pale even for my face. I swatched it on my face the other day and it was like, nah, girl. So you can see we got some acne scarring. My acne scarring like hits in a weird contour angle. So that kind of sucks, but we're gonna start applying. We're a little close though. There wasn't a primer released for this foundation. The Maybelline Stick Primer is the primer I would probably use if I wasn't just testing this one by itself. So if you guys haven't seen, that was my last video. I'll put it in the cards, that primer is. So when you take the top off, now you have no clue what shade's what. Okay, this one's natural beige. Literally the name's only on the top of the cap. Why wouldn't you put it like at the bottom of the tube too? Come on, L'Oreal. I mean, obviously if you own one shade, you'd never have this issue, but here we are. It's not bad. I wish it was a little lighter. It's definitely creamy. So with the sponge, the coverage kind of blends away to nothing. So we are gonna try a brush now. Okay, there's the coverage. We found it. It's just a little late to the party. Probably suggest some sort of flat sponge to kind of press the foundation onto the skin and build that coverage for the areas that you need it, and then use a sponge for areas that you just want lighter coverage. Maybe you don't need a lot on your forehead or you don't want a lot around your nose, then that would probably be the ideal way of applying it, unless you prefer your fingers. It is a stick foundation. It is advertised as on the go, quick and easy, so if you want to use your fingers, feel free. I personally do not enjoy when foundations only apply well with your fingers, but luckily the brush got my back right now. So for me, the areas I really like to hit are my contour cheeks area, because I have a lot of scarring, and then around my nose, because I have a lot of redness. Everything else, I'm like, cool, if it's not full or medium, I'm okay with a little light even wash. I just want an even wash. I don't want splotchiness. This is the closest match that me and my twinsies, my foundation twinsies, will find, but it's not that great of a match, guys. It really isn't. It's not bad. Like, it's not super obvious. A little bit more tanny than I would want it to be. I'm gonna take warm beige and just put that in my highlight area, since it's supposed to be one of those you can use it for your highlight, you can use it for your contour, and it is pretty creamy, so I'm not mad at it. Give a brighter look to the face. I could just go like this without any under eye concealer and be perfectly fine. I think the coverage is definitely high enough that you could get away with that, and it is pretty much full. So now we are going to try the blush. I have the blush in number 46, Cheeky Dimension. It is released in two different shades. This one is more of the rosier shade. The other one is like a baby pink, and I don't really rock baby pink blushes. So I'm gonna try to warm this up on the back of my hand first, and then just dab it on my cheeks. That's the color, if you wanted to see it there. Just blend it in with my brush. I don't mind that application. It's a nice little sheen. I can take a little bit more off the back of my hand and just add in. The fact that I can still use my foundation brush right after, and that it's creamy enough too. It hasn't broken up my foundation whatsoever, so that's nice. Let's cross our fingers for the highlight. I'm gonna get a smaller version of the brush I'm using. I'm gonna add the color. It looks kind of like a coral, almost terracotta look. The highlights, there are two, and I have both. So there is number 41, Slaying in Rose, and this is a pinkier shade. Of course, there's usually a pink, and then there's usually a gold. So the second one is number 42, which is Gold is Gold. That's what it is. Gold is Gold. Here is Slay in Rose, and here is Gold is Gold. So this depends on your undertone. The rose one, which is like the light pink, looks like this. Doesn't look very pink when you swatch it. It looks more like a pure white, almost silver highlight. While the gold doesn't even look as gold as it does in the container. It lost some of its undertones. And we've already heated up these sticks. I'm gonna try the Gold is Gold. Slay in Rose. So here we are with the highlighters, with the blush, with the foundation on, no powders yet. It's not a super dewy finish. It definitely seems like it's trying to be more of a matte finish. It has a creamy texture though, so kind of like a demi-matte. It hasn't set to a powder finish at all. So I would still add a translucent powder since I do have oily skin. I think if you had drier skin, you'd be okay without it. If you had normal skin, I think you could pull it off as well. It's not super drying and it's not super unflattering because the creaminess is very much so there. Photo-wise, the SPF looks pretty good. I don't think it's strong enough to create a noticeable white cast, at least not to me. It looks pretty good. So I'm gonna finish up my makeup, probably just, you know, do a little translucent powder, especially under my eyes, because I know my eyes will crease otherwise. And I will give you guys some starting point pictures and see you guys at the end of the day. I gotta go order that new ColourPop foundation in about 5 minutes, so I'll see you guys later today. So it's been a total of 8 hours and we are back. As you can see, I kind of did just a brow and face day. I didn't do anything with my eyes since I have, you know, my fill coming up. And I just wanted to see how the products, like I wanted to focus on my face and like, you know, just have some tousled hair. That's what we went for today. So maybe lip color would make me look a little bit more composed. Hold please. And if you guys are wondering what shade I am wearing, you're gonna have to wait and see. Yeah, that's a clip. So let's talk about the cheek products first. I did enjoy the blush, but I would say it has faded completely already. I didn't top it off with anything. The only thing that I did as far as after the camera turned off was set my under eye with some loose powder and a sponge, and then lightly, and I mean lightly, dust my face with a little bit of face powder just because I know, you know, cream foundation, oily skin, how that's gonna go without any powder whatsoever, especially, you know, hot summer months. The blush is gone. So before we try to reapply any of this, let's just get a really good look. The highlight itself is still very subtle, but still, you know, it's pretty, especially on camera. I'm not hating on it. It's just not as booming as I usually rock my highlight, but it's not a bad highlight. Everything has faded quite a bit, including the foundation. I'm gonna give you guys a really close zoom in on the foundation so you can kind of see what I'm about to tell you. Welcome to my face. I hope you guys can get a really good glance at everything. I turned down the lights and all of that. As you can see, my pores look fine. My fine lines aren't really accentuated. I didn't add any under eye concealer. I'm still rocking just the foundation underneath my eyes. It's not greasy. This is mainly just the highlight that we applied, and this does not feel greasy. It just is reflecting at certain areas. I think my problem right now would be like my forehead area not being greasy but starting to separate, and just the corners of my nose and my chin. So generally we're talking about our T-zone. The foundation doesn't look bad. The color hasn't oxidized or anything. It's just starting to separate. Like I can see the foundation, you know, break apart, like that oil separation. It's happening everywhere actually. So like here, here, here. And that itself makes the foundation look a lot heavier. The coverage is all still there. It's just starting to fade. And because of the separation, it's starting to look kind of this like splotchy, cakey. Not fully cakey, but it's getting there. So it is a full coverage foundation. I wouldn't say it's never cakey like the claims, but I wouldn't wear this for 24 hours, especially the fact that the oils are breaking through for something that's supposed to last that long. It's not a bad foundation. For a lot of things, I say From far away you can't tell, only up close, but from a good distance I can kind of tell already that it's getting kind of worn pretty fast. So that's just my thoughts. I think the price is good, I think the shades could be better, and I wouldn't prefer this over the recent stick foundation that I reviewed. I prefer that one actually, but I don't mind the blush if it lasted a little longer. I didn't set it with a powder because of the 24-hour claim. I could see myself using the blush again if I wanted something just light and fleshy like that. I probably won't use the highlighters again. So I'm not gonna give this foundation my stamp of approval as far as, you know, it's nothing too crazy. It's not horrible. It's just not something you need to run out and get right away. Make sure you hit the notification bell to be notified of my new uploads. The next foundation review will be the ColourPop No Filter Foundation. I ordered 3 different shades, the loose powders. I have the concealers on standby, and I can't wait to do that video for you guys because that's what is up next as far as foundation reviews go. I've gotten a lot of requests to start doing concealer reviews, and I used to do a few in the past, and I've done a few recently, so I'll probably start doing a few of those as well. I hope you guys are having an awesome week. Thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe if you haven't yet. And I will see you guys in a later video.